Hi, this is Sai Morton with the daily update on Eurofix. I post my exclusive market overviews with the key political and economical events, charts and important levels on the ForexBSummit.com forums weekly. This short video is a response to rapidly changing situation on the currency markets and should help you to stay on top of the game and be profitable. I suggest you to visit ForexBSummit.com forum and read my analysis for the week before watching this daily video. Greetings everybody, guys. Let's take a look at the euro currency. As market finally has reached the predefined level that we have specified previously, and here is the moment of truth. So all preparation has been done for taking the long position on the euro currency. From the market mechanics, if euro is still bullish and still keep some long-term upward momentum here, market should not drop significantly lower. Because retracement that we see and the strength of the level where markets stand right now should be enough to support real bullish market. So if market will fail with the setup that we have here, it will tell us that market is not quite bullish as it was suggested. Theoretically, of course, it could happen that market could form 1618 EBCD extension down to the 618 support. It also will be some kind of a gutless triple to buy as well. But the major tricky moment here stands in relation to the strength of the level. So take a look at the market here stands at confluence support and agreement. So AB equals CD target and confluence support. So it's rather strong level. If market will not able to hold here, what chance that market will stop at deeper support that is not as strong as this one? This is the first moment. Second moment, guys, very significant deep retracement prior to the reaching of the major target. It always looks suspicious. So that's why it could be understandable if market turns to the deep retracement as soon as market will complete AB equals CD target. But here market actually has turned down, but no real resistance exists. So there's no FIB levels here. It's mostly nothing. In such circumstances, the normal bullish market should not show very significant 618 retracement. So it will be not really good sign. That's why today we'll be focused what will happen in this area. On the 4-hour time frame chart, you could see the completion of our target, AB equals CD. So you can see that the AB and CD legs are very harmonic, so it's CD leg even slightly slower. So you can see this target has been met yesterday. It's a bit later than it should be, but this is normal. So in general, this is rather harmonic. The price action on the slope of the CD leg is a bit shows some choppiness, and that is also the good sign. So we'd not see any straight downward action, something of that sort, but in opposite direction. This is also a good sign for support. The fact that market stands slightly below the confluence support should not deceive us, so we should not worry about this, because Judd Napoli, in his book, when he spoke on some advanced moments with the FIB supports and what really could happen on the market, he said that existence of the target, some extension, if it stands slightly below or above FIB level, so in our case this resistance support that should be slightly below, doesn't mean that market has erased and break the level. And this temporal breakout stands due to the completion of the extension. As soon as market will complete the extension, it should not return right back up. That's why here, guys, it doesn't mean yet that level has been broken. So market just has completed 1788 target in this ABCD. By taking a look at the 4-hour time frame chart, what pattern could trigger the upward reversal? So definitely what I see here is could be head and shoulders. So it could become left shoulder, head. So market, theoretically, if our suggestion is correct, then the possible up prediction should turn up, reach this area around 1850, then could start forming of the right shoulder. Some reversal construction here could appear. today and tomorrow. But major moment to watch for here is, of course, the stability of the market around this level. So we do not want to get the breakout down of these lows and further downward continuation. That's why if you haven't taken a long position yet and you think about this, you could do this against these lows. Maybe you could take additional insurance by placing stops somewhere below the extensions on some moment, for example, if somehow the butterfly here will be formed. But by taking a look in the overall picture, there is no necessity for the butterfly, because first of all, you can see on the 4-hour time frame chart, market has completed the B equal city. And if you will take a look at the hourly chart, market also has completed our ABC top 161. A target already has been met. So for that, from that standpoint, market has no real necessity to taking out of these lows. For example, if XOP target was standing here, I would say that yes, we should wait for a butterfly because we have uncompleted target. But right now, all targets already have been met. So market has completed. That's why the more probable pattern that we could get here, as I've shown you, this is Gardner Chipple 2-buy. That's now is forming mining pattern. So that's why actually we probably could try to buy against these lows. It's very small stop above around 20-30 pips. It's a very attractive situation currently, guys. Also, we have this nicely looking bullish divergence on the MACD on the hourly chart. And here you also could see the our yesterday setup on the Gardner's Chipple 2 sell. So it has worked also perfectly, mostly right from the point where we have prepared our daily video. It has turned down. So now its target has been completed because our expectation was the reaching of the 1790 area. So completion of large ABCD and minor 1618 extended objective point. So that's all that I could say right now on the overcount. So if you'd like to take the long position trying to take the risk, this is very nice opportunity because you have the Gardner's Chipple 2 buy pattern is forming. Your stop will be very small. And the overall context looks attractive on the euro currency right now. Besides, as I said, if market still will break this level down, this just will change the short-term situation. It will mean that market is not as bullish as it really could be and should be. So normally, the bullish market should not break this support area where it stands right now, because it's rather strong support, and that should be sufficient to push a real bullish market higher. So that's, as I said, today's the moment of truth. So think, decide right now, the choice is up to you.